What is an equation? Someone might say, something with an equal sign. Technically, this isn't wrong, but it only gives us a superficial explanation for what they look like, without telling us much about why we write equations and how we use them. It's like if I had asked, what is a vehicle? Saying something with wheels isn't wrong, but wouldn't you say it's a weird definition, since it doesn't tell us what a vehicle does or what it is used for? Why don't we hold our mathematical definitions to the same kind of standard? For example, here is a summation. You can clearly see an equal sign here, so there is an equation somewhere in this expression, but this as a whole is not an equation. Similarly, here is an expression describing a probability, which must be between 0 and 1 by definition. Again, we can clearly see an equation inside, but the whole thing is not an equation. These are just two simple examples that demonstrate why such an arbitrary definition can be problematic. There's even an alternative way to write equations that doesn't use an equal sign, which complicates matters further. So, we have a specific word for a bunch of math symbols that specifically contains an equal sign, but not for the ones that specifically contain, say, a plus sign. Have you ever wondered, why is this unique to the equal sign? Here is the secret sauce. Equations are logical statements, meaning that they can be true or false. For example, 3 equals 3 is true, but 3 equals 4? False. Just because an equation is false doesn't mean it's not an equation, as it still has an equal sign in it. To really get a feel for this idea, let's try embedding it into spoken language. Suppose I asked you, is today is Monday true? You can respond yes or no depending on whether the statement today is Monday is true or false. Likewise, I can ask you, is 3 equals 3 true? And you can similarly respond with yes or no. But now, if I ask you, is Monday true? This will be a nonsensical question with no meaningful answer, similar to if I were to ask, is 5 true? And this is what distinguishes an expression from an equation. 5 is considered an expression because it doesn't have an equal sign to be evaluated as true or false. While some equations are always true or always false, like these two, some equations, like x equals 1, are conditionally true or false, depending on the values of the variables. Here is one particular visualization we can use for this idea. Here is a real number line. I'll mark values that make the equation true in green, and all other values that make it false in red. When we solve an equation for x, what that means is we are finding all values of x that make the equation true. In many cases, this consists of a single point or value, but there are also plenty of cases where we have more than one solution, no solution, or even all real solutions. The point is, we have to find all of them. This idea also guides the rules for what we are allowed to do with an equation. Suppose we were solving this equation. We simply subtract 1 from both sides, and we're done. But why is this allowed? If we draw the set of solutions for the first equation, then draw the set of solutions for the second equation, we can see they are identical. The move we did, subtracting 1 from both sides, preserves the set of solutions. When two statements have the same solution set, they always have the same truth value. Notice that no matter what value we choose for x, the equations are either both true or both false, never one true and one false. We say that these statements are logically equivalent. The reason why the second line is the desired answer is because it most directly answers the question of what the solutions of the equation are. Here's a natural language analogy. If you ask me, what day is it today? And I reply, tomorrow is Tuesday. You can then logically infer that it's the same as today is Monday. So these are logically equivalent. But wouldn't you agree that my answer is slightly annoying? Now let's try a few simple exercises. Pause the video if you want to give this one a try. If we do our algebra steps as usual, moving constants to the right side and variables to the left, we get something like this, which is not true. Some people may think that this is due to something wrong that they did, but this isn't always the case. To see how this could be correct, let's draw the solution set for the last line. We can see that since it is always false, the entire number line is red. Each of the steps we did was valid, so each of the lines above it must also give the exact same solution set. Now we can confirm that there are no real solutions. Be careful though. Saying an equation has no solutions is not the same as saying it is unsolvable. We did solve this equation by showing it has no solutions. Here is another problem, this time a bit trickier. Once again, pause if you want to give this one a shot. So this problem is a little unusual, and there are a couple of things that make it so. We want the values of a and b, two of the unknowns, but there is only one equation, and on top of that, how do we make it so that the equation is always true no matter what x is? Let's try it this way. First, can you think of any equation at all that is true for all x? Some simple examples might include x equals x, or even more simply, 1 equals 1, or 0 equals 0. The key here is to eliminate x entirely so that we can get the equation to match this form. To do this, we first distribute and gather like terms. Now we set the coefficients here equal to each other, which tells us that both sides will always be equal to each other, no matter what x is. Finally, just solve the system to obtain our values for a and b. Okay, one more example problem. Pause if you want to try it. So if you don't know where to begin, you could start by multiplying out the denominator. We can now subtract 4x on both sides. Uh-oh, what now? It looks like no matter what value we pick for c, we will always be able to solve for x. How can we pick any c value that would give us no solutions for x? Notice that in the first equation, plugging in x equals 3 results in a division by 0, which will not be able to give us a solution no matter what. Therefore, we want to find the value of c in the second equation that gives us x equals 3. Plug in x equals 3, solve for c, and we have our answer. To get an intuition for why this c value causes problems, notice two things. First of all, if you plug in our c value, then factor out a 6 from the top, you can cancel like factors to obtain a false equation. Any other c value would mean that the factors won't cancel. The second way to intuit this is to plug in x equals 3, and notice that not only are we dividing by 0, but the numerator is also 0. 0 divided by 0 is special, being something called an indeterminate form. It means that it is not only undefined, but there exists a context for which it could equal anything. Since we don't have any further context, this is not a solution, as 0 divided by 0 is undefined. So, what did we learn? We've learned that there's a particular way of looking at equations that can help us think about them more flexibly from different perspectives. It helps us understand how not to miss any solutions or accept extraneous solutions, and as a result, how we can manipulate equations. This idea can also be extended, as equations are not the only kinds of mathematical logical statements. For example, inequalities, among other things, are logical statements too. It's a valuable habit to keep these concepts in mind when doing math, as they reveal the underlying motivations and techniques beneath the problem and the topic you are working on. For example, for further exploration, how come squaring both sides of an equation potentially gives extraneous solutions, while square rooting both sides of an equation can result in missed solutions? Even more generally, when are we allowed to apply a function to both sides of an equation? So, what is an equation? It is a logical statement that two expressions have the same value, usually denoted by writing an equal sign between them. This is a better description that not only captures the syntactic definition, the superficial symbol analysis, but also the semantic usage, how and why we use equations, in a way that will help us better understand how to handle them. If you like my work and would like to support me, please check out my AbleBees profile. On the AbleBees website, you'll be able to start a petition requesting content from me, or pitch in to an existing petition. If enough people pitch in, I will accept the petition and the video will be made. There is also no risk to you, as you won't be charged unless I deliver the content. So if there's that one topic you really want me to cover, come start or join a petition. Otherwise, as usual, thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed my content, please like, subscribe, and share this video. See you all next time.